can win this beautiful car on the turn of a single card on Card Sharks. And if you play your cards right, you can win $32,000. And now, the host of Card Sharks, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. We're glad you could join us today. We have a lot of money. We have a new car to give away. We have two very delightful contestants. But before we meet our contestants, let's say hi to our two pretty dealers. Here they are. They're with us every morning. Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams are the dealers on Card Sharks. Aren't they pretty?
Good morning.
Good morning. They're so nice and fresh today.
Thank you.
If you would deal out the cards from the top, we'll get it going. All right. Come on, Card Sharks. Please join me. Our champion and our new challenger. Hey, Gloria. How are you, Gloria?
Fine. My name is Gloria Kisner. I'm from the British West Indies. I love to travel and I love to play tennis.
Now, what does your husband do?
My husband works for an insurance company. We work for the same company.
Oh, do you really? Does that present a problem?
No, we used to work on the same floor, but that was all right, too.
Is that how you met?
Yes.
Oh. You little devil. You won $6,100 so far.
I'm very happy.
Well, you should be very happy. We have a new challenger. Hi, Sharon. How are
you? Hi, Bob. I'm Sharon McMurtry. I am married. I have two lovely boys. I am a flight attendant for 18 years now. I started flying when I was 12.
And you were 12. Mm-hmm. All right, fine.
Yeah. Gotcha. That makes me like 20-something.
Yes. All right, if you win two games, you're our champion. That's all you have to remember. Let's get it going right now. First question, first game goes to you, Gloria. And this question, all this week, by the way, in our studio audience, we have 10 Soviet immigrants. And we've had some very interesting stories, so they're back with us again today. All right, this question involves our 10 Soviet immigrants, Gloria. Before the show, we ask our 10 Soviet immigrants, as far as you know, was your mail ever censored when you lived in the Soviet Union? How many of these 10 Soviet immigrants said their mail was censored?
Gee, I do not know a whole lot about the Soviet, but my guess would be five.
Five of them, you think, had their mail censored. Sharon,
yes.
What do you think?
Bob, I think living in the Soviet Union, I think it's going to be a little bit higher.
Think it might even be higher than that. Well, the actual number of these Soviet immigrants who said their mail was censored when they lived in the Soviet Union is 9 of them. Yeah, 9 of them. I'm amazed at that. Which 9 of you? Please raise your hand. No kidding. I only see 8. 1. Max.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Did we wake you, Max? I'm really sorry. Now, this is so fascinating. Jury, where are you? Do I pronounce it Yuri or Jury?
Yuri.
Yuri, okay. Now, how many people in the Soviet Union? How many millions of people?
About 270 million.
Now, what I find fascinating, 270 million people, 9 of the 10 of you had your mail censored. Does that mean that almost everybody gets their mail censored?
Actually, I work for a while in a place when they do check mail and packages coming to the Russia. Most of the time done in random, but they do check that.
But they do check, and they did check yours?
Yes. As a matter of fact, one of my friends, I mean my co-worker, checked one of my mail. And he told me that.
But your co-worker checked your mail. Did you check his back?
Unfortunately, I wasn't in the power to do so.
Oh, okay. Thank you. It's very interesting. Nice to have you with us. All right. Who's got all this control? Sharon does? All right, Sharon, card's yours. Here we go. There's a 6 for you.
I'm going to go higher, Bob.
Higher than the 6? How about a queen?
I'm going to go lower, Bob.
Lower than a queen. 6
I'm
again.
I'm going to go higher.
Higher again. 7.
Oh, my gosh. I'm going to freeze. I'm going to freeze.
Freeze on the old 7.
I'm a chicken.
How's Gloria doing? Gloria, you all right? Gloria says, what are you doing? Okay. We'll be back in just a moment with more Card Sharks right after this.
Door number, it's how to get the money you need.
Welcome back to Card Sharks. Now we're going to continue with our game between Gloria and our new challenger, Sharon. Sharon, this is your question. Sharon, we surveyed 100 people and we asked them, if you discovered that the presidential candidate of your choice was living with a woman out of wedlock, would you vote for him anyway? How many people would vote for their candidate anyway?
Well, I would. I not that I really think that I approve of someone living with a married man living with a woman, but I think I wouldn't let that affect my vote.
I didn't ask that.
Yeah.
You know, if the presidential candidate of your choice was living with a woman out of wedlock, would you vote for him anyway?
Oh, out of wedlock. I'm sorry. Okay, out of wedlock. I still would vote for him, of course.
Oh, okay.
I lived with my husband before I got married, and I don't think that has... I did. And I'm okay. I am. I don't think it's... I think that's okay. I really do. I don't think that has anything to do with what the judgment that he's going to make after he becomes the president, because they all make kind of stupid things anyway. So I'm going to say...
How many people would vote for their candidate anyway?
A lot. I'm going to say 65.
65 out of 100. Gloria, what do you think about this one, high or lower?
I would say slightly lower, Bob.
Slightly lower than that?
I would vote for him.
All right. The actual number of people who would vote for their candidate, even if he was living with a woman, is 52. You're right, it was slightly lower, Gloria. All right, Gloria, you have the control now, my dear, and there for you is a deuce.
Higher.
Higher than a deuce, how about a three?
Higher.
Higher than a three, how about a nine? I'll freeze in the old nine. Yes, okay. So she'll freeze right there. Okay, next question. This is yours, Gloria. We surveyed 100 bachelors, and we asked them, have you ever told a girl you loved her when you weren't really sure you meant it? How many bachelors have done that?
Well, I think a lot of men do that just to get what they want with women.
What do you mean?
Well, I had a boyfriend once who told me he loved me. But, you know, deep down, I knew he didn't love me. He just liked going out with me, maybe going to the movies, dinner.
Oh, that's what you meant. Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah. But, you know, and see the girls when it's convenient. So I would say about 55.
55 out of 100 bachelors have done that. Told a girl that they loved him when they weren't sure they really did.
Right.
Sharon, higher or lower?
I think they all tell you that they love you. I think they all do that. They all told me that they loved me. And I think that's going to be higher.
Even higher?
Oh, yeah.
Actual number of bachelors who have told a girl they loved her when they weren't really sure is 61. Your bet it was higher. Okay, Sharon, you froze on the 7.
That card.
We'll change that card. Oh, 7 now Ace. Becomes a 7 again.
Well, higher, it's got to be.
All right, if it's higher, you win game number 1. Is it higher? No, not higher. Gloria, you get a free chance with a 9.
Higher.
Higher than the 9. Nope. Not higher than the 9. So we made no progress at all. We'll try another question then. You ever been in prison, Sharon?
Oh, no, not lately. Uh-uh.
Well, we surveyed 100 women who are serving time in prison. This is sudden death, you guys, right? Fourth and final question. Someone has to win the game in the next play of the cards.
Okay. Women?
Yes, we surveyed 100 women who are serving time in prison. We asked them, right now, are you wearing makeup? How many women inmates said they were?
Probably not very many, because most women in prison, I think, are pretty doggy. You know, I don't know, but I think that most of them, like, have committed bad crimes and stuff, and I think that they might not really take care of themselves too much. So I'm going to say that's a pretty high number, that they don't wear makeup. I'm going to say 55.
How many women inmates said they were wearing makeup?
Oh, they were? Mm-hmm. 35.
35 out of 100 women inmates said they were wearing makeup. What do you think, Gloria, higher or lower?
I don't know. I think in spite of the fact they're in prison, they still feel sexy and like women. So I'd say it's higher.
You think it's higher?
Yeah.
The actual number of women inmates who are wearing makeup is 35 of them. How's that?
Oh, my God.
How about that? 35 on the button I have for you.
I thought I was wrong.
Five $100 bills. There they are. 1, 2, 3, 4, and all 5.
Thank you so much.
For you.
Thank you.
All right. Not only that, this is sudden death. So you got a couple of choices to make. You can change the 7 and play it out. If you goof, Gloria wins the game, or pass it on to Gloria. She must play off the 9. If she goofs, you win the game.
I'm going to pass it.
Pass it to Gloria. All right, Gloria.
Higher.
Higher than the 9 it is.
Lower.
Gonna go lower. If it's lower, you win the game. If it's not lower, Sharon wins the game. Lower than the 10, it is. And Gloria wins the game. Whoa! You're tough, lady. You are tough. All right, we'll be right back with more Card Sharks, and we'll set up for game number 2 right after this.
There we go.
All right, we are ready now with game number 2. Gloria wins the game. Sharon, you have to win this game to stay in the match. Let's see what happens. And the first question goes to you, Gloria. This question involves our 10 Soviet immigrants in our studio audience who are ready to play the game with us. How nice of you to join us again, too. Gloria, before the show, we asked these 10 Soviet immigrants, did you come to America without knowing a word of English? How many of these 10 Soviet immigrants did come to America without knowing one word of English?
When you say one word, you literally mean like one word.
A word of English. Don't make my job hard, Gloria.
Oh, I would say they would know at least something. I'd say around five.
Five of them came to America without knowing a word of English. Sharon, higher or lower?
A word of English? Lower than that.
Think it might be lower than that? The actual number of these Soviet immigrants who came to America without knowing a word of English is six of them. Six of them. Not lower, it was a little bit higher. How interesting. Okay, raise your hand. Which six of you did that? If you would, please. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay. Yeah, I was checking your Russian math, that's all. Leonid, what'd you do? I mean, how'd you get started?
It was difficult. About a couple of months after I came, I went to a department store to get some hangers, and I didn't know the word hanger. But I knew it has something to do with hooking.
Ah.
So I asked for hookers.
Hookers! Hookers! Sure. And they were probably cheaper than the hangers, weren't they?
Yes. In Cincinnati, they are.
Yeah, thank you very much. It's a wonderful story. I like that. Gloria, you ready? There, Gloria, is a three for you.
Higher
than a three. How about a 10?
I'll freeze.
Oh, freeze?
I'm coward.
I'm coward, she says. Okay, I got an educated guess question now. Sharon, this educated guess. In what percentage of American marriages is the wife older than her husband? In what percentage?
Oh, nowadays, a few more. I'm going to say a pretty even number, though. I'm going to say 45%.
45%. Let's see what Gloria says.
I would say slightly lower, Bob.
Think it might be lower?
Yeah.
The actual percentage of American marriages in which the wife is older than her husband is 22%. Yes, it was considerably lower.
Yeah.
All right, Gloria's got the control again. Now, Gloria, you change the 10?
Yes.
Well, all right, Lacey's got a new card for you. How about a king?
Lower.
Lower than a king. How about a 10 again?
Can I freeze again?
Certainly you can.
I will.
Okay. No, she freezes. That keeps Sharon off the card. So far, it's working.
Yeah.
Let's try another one then. This is yours, Gloria. We surveyed 100 women who have gotten a divorce within the last 6 months. We asked them, if your ex-husband wanted to get back together again, would you be willing to give it a try? How many divorced women said they would be willing to give it a try?
Well, I'm divorced, and I mean, my ex-husband and I are good friends, but I really wouldn't want to be married to him again. So I would have to say that number is around 45.
45. Sharon, what do you think?
I agree with her. I'm divorced also. And I like my ex-husband as a friend also, but I wouldn't want to be married to him again.
It would make your present husband mad, probably.
It might. Well, that might happen, yeah.
Sure,
I don't think he would like that a bit. Well, so I think it's maybe even lower than that.
Even lower than that,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, I think so.
Actual number of divorced women who'd be willing to give it a try is 19 of them. Yeah.
Thank you.
A whole lot lower.
Thank you.
All right, Sharon, here we go. Your card is an 8.
Change it, please.
You will. 8 is now. Jack.
Lower, Bob.
Lower than the Jack 6.
Higher, Bob.
Is it higher? Yes.
Oh, lower, Bob.
Going lower. Got it.
Higher, Bob, please.
In order to win the game and tie it up, higher than a 5.
Ow.
Yeah. Lady round the card. Good for you. Another $100 for you. Well, that makes things a little tight, doesn't it? One game for each player, which means two games and you're the champ. We'll play a tiebreaker game. In the tiebreaker, it's a one-question sudden-death game. The girls will deal out only three cards this time. Winner of this game is the champ, and Sharon, the question is yours. We surveyed 100 women who have had a nose job. We asked them, after you got your new nose, did you destroy any pictures of yourself with your old nose? How many women did destroy some pictures showing their old nose?
Oh, a lot of them. A lot of them did. Because if sometimes even if my picture doesn't turn out right, if something's out of place on my face or something.
Did you have a nose job?
No, I didn't have a nose job. Should I?
No. Just curious.
But I think that women, yeah, I think they would tear up their pictures, some of them. So I'm going to say, 53.
53 out of 100 did destroy some pictures showing their old nose. Gloria?
I will say a little higher.
A little higher than
yeah.
that? The actual number of women who destroyed pictures that showed their old nose is only 7 of them. Only 7 of them. No, it was lower. Okay, Sharon, you got a couple of choices to make now. I'm going to show you your base card, then I'll show you Gloria's base card, and we'll see what kind of a decision you want to make. Gloria, your base card, Sharon, is a 5. You can change that card if you want to. Gloria's base card is a king. Now, you can play it or you can pass it. Up to you.
I'm going to pass it, Bob.
You're going to pass it. Okay. Here's the situation, Gloria. Mm-hmm. If you make a mistake, Sharon's the champ.
All right? Lower.
Lower than the king? No! We got a new champ, and it's Sharon. Whoa, tough game. Tough game.
I'm sorry.
All right, Gloria, you end up with $6,200 in cash. Thank
I'm
you very
happy.
Much for being with us. And we'll see you again. All right, Sharon, right over here, my dear. We got a new champ. We come back, we're going to give our new champ a chance to win a lot of money and a brand new car. So we'll be right back for that.
My 4
1 hour. 888-411-LAWS.
Welcome back to Card Shark. Sharon's a new champ, and now we're going to give you a chance to win a lot of money, because in addition to all the money you can win over there, we've added a couple of jokers to the deck. Every time a joker pops up, heck, that gives you a chance of winning a brand new car. And because you are the champ, you won the last 2 games, Lacey's got a joker for you, so you know you at least have 1 chance of winning that car. We're going to give the lady $200 to bet with. You got it, Sharon? Good luck to you.
Here we go.
All right, Sharon. Your first card happens to be an ace. How's that?
All of it lower
than the A's. Oh, $400.
All of it higher
than the 3. Oh, 10.
Change
800.
That card. Number 3, please.
Number 3.
Okay.
The lady will change the card.
On,
the 10
baby.
Will now become a queen. Woo! You got 800.
800. 600 lower.
$600 lower than the queen. Is it lower? It is lower. Yeah. $1,400 up here. I'll
all
give you another $400. You got 1,800.
All of it higher. Stay with me, baby.
Higher than the deuce. Sure it is. Now you
change
got 3,600.
Okay,
here we go. The 9
come on,
now
baby.
Becomes a queen. 3,600.
3,600. $2,000 lower.
$2,000 lower
yes.
than the queen. All right, be there.
Come on,
lower
baby.
Than the queen. Yeah.
$5,600,
Sharon.
$5,600. Oh my gosh. 3,000 higher.
3,000.
Yes.
3,000
yes,
higher
please.
Than the 6. Whoa. Oh. Just barely. $8,600.
How much do I
up here comes the 8. You're going to play
it,
a change.
Change it. Please. Come on,
sure.
deuce. Ace.
Okay. Let's see what the 8 is. 8 is now a king.
Oh my God.
Now, Sharon, here are your options. You got $8,600. You got to bet at least half of it. What are you going to do?
I'm going to go $6,600 lower.
$6,600.
Come on,
lower
baby.
Lower than the king. It is.
Oh.
There you go. $15,200 what
oh
you win first
God.
Time out. Not bad at all. And we're not even done yet. You got 15,900 so far. That's your total winnings. Lacey has for you a joker. I want you to take a look over here now. We've got 7 numbered cards. Behind one of them is this brand new car. Jane?
The Buick Skyhawk Coupe. The sports car with room and comfort, equipped with standard features, plus pinstripes and California emission. Good luck, Sharon.
All right, Sharon. 7 numbered cars. Behind one of them is the word car. If you can find the car, well, that's the car you will win. So good luck to you. Go put that joker wherever you want it to be. All right, behind number 4. If it's there, you are the winner of the car, along with the $15,900 in cash. Not bad at all. Is it behind number 4? Let's find out, because behind number 4 is the word. Where is it today? Ah, it was behind number 3 today, Sharon.
Right next door.
Real close. Real close. Okay, we'll be back with more Card Sharks right after this. Don't go away. You won $15,900.
Oh! I can't believe it.
Not bad.
I can't believe it. I almost bet it all, but I can't really make it up.
Here is your first subject. Go.
Okay, big celebrities.
People you respect.
Dick Clark.
People who are older than you.
Hugging, winning.
Things with an X?
No, it's things you see on the $25,000 pyramid today at 10 a.m. Eastern, only on Game Show Network.
800-229-8383. Call now.
Well, all the time we have for today, our champ wins $15,900. First time playing the big money. Not bad at all. She'll be back next time, and at that time we'll meet a new challenger for her, and we hope that you'll be back too. For Lacey Pemberton, Susanna Williams, Gene Wood, and the whole gang, I'm Bob Eubanks. Thank you very much for watching Card Sharks. We're glad you did. See you next time.
Stick around. You won't want to miss Richard Dawson's next kissing spree on Family Feud, followed by the classic match game of the 70s and the 90s update.
Cliff Sandees, did you get three whammies or four? In all the excitement, we kind of lost track ourselves. But seeing as how a whammy can wipe out all your earnings with a press of a button, and four whammies knocks you clear out of the game, you may be asking yourself a question. Do I feel lucky? Well, do ya, Cliff? Press your luck every day at 9:30 and 1:30 Eastern, every night at 9:30 and 1:30 Eastern, only on Game Show Network. Go ahead, press it.